In this video, we're going to take a first look on the new data blending feature in Google Data Studio. All and more coming up. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and we are live right now talking about the new Data Studio feature of data blending. Now, if you are aware of our other tutorials we did on Data Studio, you might know that we took the workaround at that time, at least, to pull in data to Google Sheets, blend it together, and then importing it into our Data Studio dashboard. This gave us a lot of flexibility, but at the same time was a little bit inconvenient. Now, Google has done something about it, or at least the Google Data Studio team, because they have announced the community connectors that actually let us pull in data from different data sources than the Google products into Google Data Studio. So we can now pull data through third-party connectors like Supermetrics directly into Data Studio with these new functionalities of these data connectors, and that is important for Facebook ads. Now, what we were not able to do is actually take that data and then blend it together with other data sources. What do I mean by blending? Well, if you wanted to have data from Facebook ads and Google Analytics in one table or in one visualization, that was not possible to do within Google Data Studio. You would still need to go back, for example, to a third-party system like Google Sheets or a database, blend that data there together, and put it then into Google Data Studio. This has now been fixed with a new feature of data blending within Google Data Studio, and we're gonna take a first look. So without further ado, let's dive right into our little demo here. So I'm here at Data Studio. Let's just come up with a completely new report. And at the beginning, we are asked to choose our data sources. Now I've already connected my Facebook account and my Google Analytics account. I actually want to just demo this, and let's find out how many clicks we had on our Facebook ads campaign. So I'm adding this to my report, and we get our familiar canvas here. Now I will work with dates, so I'm gonna just put this date picker right here and select the range. Now let's go to some old data we have in the system from November. Let's go with the 15th here. Okay, so this is already put in here. Now the next thing I wanna do is actually make a table, and in this table, I want to show my Facebook ads, not by campaign name, but actually by the date. So up here, we can choose our dimensions and our metrics. What I want to do is choose the date dimension. So we have up here time, and this is the Supermetrics connector to Google Data Studio that you can then connect to your Facebook ads account. I have done this in this case. We'll simply go with the date dimension. And as you might know, dates are in a spreadsheet. They are really the columns that you put in here. Now for the rows, I actually want to not have impressions here. I want to show the actual clicks that we had on our campaigns. So I'm gonna go here to campaigns and go with the link clicks. And let's get rid of, well, we can leave in the impressions, doesn't really matter. Now, what I want to do is actually know how many people converted. What I can do from my Google, or from my Facebook data, is obviously if I use the conversion tracking of Facebook, I can put that in as well. But Facebook will always give me different data. Maybe that would be a great thing to actually compare. If I can find the right metric here, because as you might be aware, the website conversion value, the Facebook API gives us a lot of data to look into. And I'm not quite sure how I've tagged this, if this is just a custom conversion. Let's see if that does the trick. Yes, we have custom conversions here. So this is what Facebook actually records from the Facebook pixel. Now I want to compare this with Google Analytics data, right? Google Analytics has a different attribution modeling going on, because you might know that Facebook is really looking just at how many people come to the website, click, and then convert. And they look back, if there was any contact point with Facebook, it will be attributed to Facebook, and Facebook will show that. Google Analytics is different to that, because it's last click wins, or the last source that brought the traffic to your website and then converted. How many people are that, and how does that compare to Google Analytics? Now, I could do this in spreadsheets, obviously, but for our demonstration here, we want to actually blend this data with our Facebook ads data. And there is this new functionality on here under data sources where we see blend data. And I'm gonna click this. This opens up this new menu down here where we have our data sources, and we can blend multiple data sources to each other, or into each other, I guess. The data source that we are predominantly using right here is Facebook ads. This will be our primary data set. And I'm gonna add a data set to it, and available sources here, I've already connected this, is my Google Analytics account. So I'm gonna add this to the report. Now we have two reports in here, and we want to join this. Now, in order to join data with each other, you will need to have a join key. Join key and databases, they're also called primary keys, are date metrics that you have in both data sources that are aligned to each other. So in our case, it would be the date. Obviously, the date is in Google Analytics and in Facebook ads, and it would match that up correctly. What you could also do, if you have tagged your UTM parameters in your Facebook ads correctly, is do that through, for example, the source medium or the landing page or so. You need to have a join key in order to align this to the data sources together. And we have date here, so that is all fine. Now the last thing I wanna do, can we make this a little bit bigger, is to actually add a metric to this. Now that the data is aligned, we can add the metric. And in our case, I want to just take a goal completion. Now in my case, it would be the email sign up. Find the right one here. That is the goal completion, yes. And we'll just drag that in. Let's save this. And see what it does for our table. Now we have our email signups in here. Now you might notice that this is kind of skewed, because we have that many link clicks and we have so many email signups. So it's much higher than we would expect here for the clicks that we are getting on this day. Maybe it's much higher. It's actually, yeah, a little bit beneath that. But what you always need to keep in mind is that when you pull data from a second data source, that doesn't mean that it's automatically filtered based on the data source that it's connected to. So in our case, we actually would need to say, or these email signups that we see right here are email signups that are originated from maybe different sources that came into our Google Analytics account. These are the totals of all goal completions on that day, just added to this this table here. And therefore, we need to go in and actually implement a filter. So we can add a filter here, and we'll just call this Facebook traffic. We want to, the data source is master, and only include, we have here our dimensions. Let's go with the source medium, and the condition should contain facebook.com. I think that's what I entered as the UTM parameter, so that should be correct. Let's just save this. Save this again. And now our data should be filtered down, or at least that column of email signups, to only the Facebook data. So here we go. We see that it's much lower and the sources have been attributed differently. So we can look at what Facebook actually says it generated, 71, what Google Analytics says it generated from our Facebook source. Quite interesting to see. Now, if I would be honest, I would like to know the conversion rates, right? So I would like to put in another column here saying, okay, what is the conversion rates between the link clicks and the website conversions? This is easily done for a native data source. So if we have Facebook ads just as a data source or just Google Analytics, we could build a custom metric or a custom calculated metric from this. Unfortunately, this is not something you can easily do, or not something I found in the interface at least, to be something that you can do in the blended data form. So once you use blended data, the custom metrics are out of the play. So you can't you can't calculate the link clicks conversion rate to the email signups of goal completion form. That said, probably something that they're going to fix at some point. For now, if you really need to do this, I guess you would need to go to something like Google Sheets Connector again, and do this first in Google Sheets and then import the data. But overall, a pretty interesting feature that they have added, and it was something that people needed. It also just simply breaks up the whole data siloing, right? You have data silos, now you can import them into one dashboard, but they're still silos in itself, but now you can blend them together and have much more interesting insights, I think, in terms of comparing data, putting it together from different systems. That is really the power of building a custom dashboard than just looking at a dashboard in Google Analytics or in Facebook ads. This is something that we dearly needed, and it's now implemented into Google Data Studio. All right, that's it for this little demo. If you have any more questions, then please leave them in the comments below. We also have new videos coming out all the time and live streams, so be sure to subscribe to this channel and also check out this video. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.